Good evening and welcome to St. Mary's Episcopal Church. I'm Fran Holliday, the rector, and I invite you tonight to join us in our sanctuary from the comfort of your home and worship with us on this holy night. I would like to thank Tom and Amy Cagle for making this possible with all of their filming help, and Gail Head, who is playing the organ tonight. I also want to thank John Amrine for joining me on the altar, and parishioners Peter and Catherine Carroll for filming at home, as well as our deacon Mike Choquette. I invite you to light a candle, to print off or download the bulletin we have provided so that you can pray with us and join with us in this celebration. And we will begin tonight with some pre-service music played by Gail. You may listen or you may sing along from home. Thank you.
Thank you.
Alleluia, unto us a child is born.
Oh, come, let us adore him. Alleluia.
True light. Grant that we who have known the mystery of that light on earth may also enjoy him perfectly in heaven, where with you and the Holy Spirit he lives and reigns, one God, in glory everlasting. Amen.
A reading from the book of Isaiah. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation. You have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. The word of the Lord.
Sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the whole earth.
Sing to the Lord and bless his name. Proclaim the good news of his salvation from day to day.
Declare his glory among the nations and his wonders among all peoples.
For great is the Lord and greatly to be praised. He is more to be feared than all gods.
As for all the gods of the nations, they are but idols, but it is the Lord who made the heavens.
Oh, the majesty and magnificence of his presence! Oh, the power and the splendor of his sanctuary!
Ascribe to the Lord, you families of the peoples, ascribe to the Lord honor and power.
Ascribe to the Lord the honor due his name. Bring offerings and come into his courts.
Worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Let the whole earth tremble before him.
Tell it out among the nations. The Lord is king. He has made the world so firm that it cannot be moved. He will judge the peoples with equity.
Let the heavens rejoice and let the earth be glad. Let the sea thunder and all that is in it. Let the field be joyful and all that is therein.
Then shall all the trees of the wood shout for joy before the Lord when he comes to judge the earth.
He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with his truth.
A reading from the letter to Titus. For the grace of God has appeared, bringing salvation to all, training us to renounce impiety and worldly passions, and in the present age to live lives that are self-controlled, upright, and godly, while we wait for the blessed hope and the manifestation of the glory of our great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. He it is who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify for himself a people of his own who are zealous for good deeds. The word of the Lord.
Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
In those days, a decree went out from the Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was a descendant from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged, and to who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for him in the inn. In that region there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger. And suddenly there were with the angels a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heavens, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all that they have heard and seen, as it had been told to them. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Tonight, on this holiest of nights, as we celebrate the birth of Christ, I am standing here greeting you from an almost empty sanctuary. This is a Christmas like no other. It is a Christmas in the year of a pandemic. As I have walked around the church building this week, I cannot help but notice the silence. There are no choir practices, no hustle and bustle to get bulletins out in the office, no parishioners stopping by with greetings, no phone calls from visitors from out of town wondering when our services are, no festive coffee hours or parties. It is a year devoid of all of that. Just the other day, a parishioner remarked to me as we were talking on the phone that they would not be traveling home for Christmas this year. They're not baking or shopping either. They're not going to Christmas concerts or singing carols with the neighbors. "It is," she said, "just hard to believe that everything that makes Christmas Christmas isn't happening at all." This is true for so many of us. The normal things that accompany Christmas, the big dinners, the family gatherings, traveling home, singing at midnight mass, much of it has all been curtailed. Most of us will not be participating in any of these activities. And yet, the truth is that it is Christmas, one of the holiest nights of the year, and nothing can change that reality. Tonight we are coming to you from the sanctuary of St. Mary's and also taping others from home to proclaim the timeless words spoken by the angel to a small ragtag group of shepherds who were alone on a Judean hillside watching their flocks by night. The angel said, "Do not be afraid. I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. For today is born for you in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. These words and that holy birth, that child wrapped in bands of cloth lying in a manger, this reality can never be changed. How we celebrate personally, or how we celebrate as a church, does not change the love of God that broke into our world over 2,000 years ago. The miracle of God with us as one of us, the miracle of the incarnation, the Word made flesh, this reality can never be altered. It is as powerful tonight as it ever was. God came to us as a child, with us, to be one of us, in all of our human frailty, difficulty, and to stand with us in our struggles, to be with us in the midst of our hardships and disappointments. Many of us need to hear these words now more than ever this year. Even if your own life has not been altered much, one must recognize the many lives around us that have been upended by death, illness, financial struggles, as well as isolation. Many of the normal problems of day-to-day life and challenges have indeed been compounded by the pandemic. This is perhaps the year when we need to hear the angel's words like never before. Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy for all the people. God came into the world, and tonight we are celebrating this reality, no matter what else is going on around us. It reminds me of that wonderful children's story written by Dr. Seuss, where the grumpy Grinch tries to put an end to Christmas in Whoville by stealing all of the signs of Christmas while the Whos were asleep. He stole their Christmas trees, their wreaths, all their decorations, and their food for the Christmas feast. Then he waited on Christmas morning to see how the Whos would react. And to his surprise, he heard singing in celebration as they welcomed Christmas morning nonetheless. And as he listened, he realized that he did not really understand the true meaning of Christmas at all. He had not stolen it. And what follows is his revelation is this timeless poem. It came without ribbons, it came without bows, it came without packages, boxes, and bags. Maybe Christmas, he thought, doesn't come from a store. Maybe Christmas means a little bit more. Maybe for us as Christians, this is the year when we come to realize that Christmas comes not by our doing, but by God's doing. It comes without the trappings that we need or want. It comes without crowded churches and chancel choirs. It comes without us physically being assembled all together in our building. It comes regardless of whether or not we mark the occasion with all of our favorite activities. The spirit and power of Christmas that came into the world is still with us. Nothing can ever change that. Tonight is like no other we have ever celebrated, but it is the night of that holy birth, the miracle of the incarnation. No matter where you are tonight or what you're doing or the circumstances that you find yourselves in, I hope that if nothing else, you will stop and take a moment in stillness and in quiet, and give thanks to God for the love that entered our world that is still with us forevermore. I pray that you will hear the angels again, or for the very first time. Do not be afraid, for I bring you good news of great joy for all the people. For today is born for you in the city of David, a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. Amen.
Please stand as we profess our faith by saying together the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again with glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Let us pray for the church and for the world, that the peaceable kingdom of God, refreshed in us at Christmas, be known to all the world. Let us pray to God.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our own beloved country, that we may find the will and the ways to protect all people from harm and violence, as God would have us do. Let us pray to God. Lord, hear our prayer. For the people of God gathered in worship on this holy night, that we continue in new and fresh ways both to be good news and to bring that good news to all the communities we serve. Let us pray to God.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are away from home and family this Christmas, especially our men and women in the military, for their safety and for an end to all war and conflict. Let there be peace on earth, goodwill to all. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who have gone before us in the hope of eternal life and light, family and friends, those known and unknown, whom we now remember at Christmas, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let us pray. Loving God, Christ, Prince of Peace, Wonderful Counselor, be present to us in new and bright ways as we seek to become ever more strong, loving, and wise in our life's journey, one of loving service always. May we be guided by your Holy Spirit, that we too become light to the world, light that darkness cannot and will not overcome. In the name of the newborn Jesus, the Holy One of God. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
Thank you.
with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
All thanks and praise are yours at all times and in all places, our true and loving God. Through Jesus Christ, your eternal word, the wisdom from on high by whom you created all things. You brought forth all creatures of the earth and gave breath to humankind. Wondrous are you, Holy One of blessing. All you create is a sign of hope for our journey. And so as the morning stars sing your praises, we join the heavenly beings and all creation as we say, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Glory and honor are yours, Creator of all. Your word has never been silent. You call the people to yourself as a light to the nations. You delivered them from bondage and led them to a land of promise. Of your grace, you gave Jesus to be human, to share our life, to proclaim the coming of your holy reign, and give himself for us, a fragrant offering. Through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, you have freed us from sin, brought us into your life, reconciled us to you, and restored us to the glory you intended for us. We thank you that on the night before he died for us, Jesus took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it, gave it to his friends, and said, "Take, eat, this is my body broken for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." As supper was over, Jesus took the cup of wine, said the blessing, gave it to his friends, and said, "Drink this, all of you. This cup is the new covenant in my blood, poured out for you and for all, for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." And so, remembering all that was done for us, the cross, the tomb, the resurrection, and ascension, longing for Christ's coming in glory, and presenting to you these gifts your earth has formed and human hands have made, we acclaim you, O Christ. Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Christ Jesus, come in glory. Send your Holy Spirit upon us and upon these gifts of bread and wine, so that they may be to us the body and blood of your Christ. Grant that we, burning with your Spirit's power, may be a people of hope, justice, and love. Giver of life, draw us together in the body of Christ, and in the fullness of time gather us, with Blessed Mary of Nazareth and all your people, into the joy of our true eternal home. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, we worship you, God and Creator, in voices of unending praise. Blessed are you now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen.
Alleluia, Christ our Passover is sacrificed for us.
Therefore
let us keep the feast.
Alleluia.
These are the gifts of God, and we are the people of God. Join me in our closing prayer. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food and the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now I invite you to join me at home lighting a candle as we sing Silent Night.
Silent Night.
Christ the Savior is born.
Lord, at thy birth.
On this holy night, may the blessing of God be with you, the peace of Christ be with you, and the Spirit's outpouring be with you, tonight and evermore. Amen.
Alleluia, go forth into the world rejoicing in the birth of our Lord and King.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia.